Good Clinical Practice, or GCP, is an international ethical and scientific quality standard for designing, conducting, recording and reporting clinical trials that involve the participation of human subjects. Regardless of whether a clinical trial is a large, multi-center study in patients or a small clinical pharmacological study in healthy subjects, the relevant GCP standard should be followed by the sponsoring company of the healthcare product, the investigators, the ethics committees and any clinical research organizations. Companies undertaking a clinical trial should develop written procedures for implementing GCP. Such procedures may include, but are not limited to, the following. Investigator site selection. Regulatory document collection, review and submission. Financial disclosure. Investigator site initiation. Investigational product distribution and tracking. Clinical monitoring of investigator site. Investigator site closeout. Safety reporting. Quality assurance audits. Required documents for study master file and document retention. Vendor qualification and oversight, for example, contract research organization. And indemnity, compensation, and insurance. Prior to the GCP guidance document developed by the International Conference on Harmonization, ICH, different jurisdictions had different guidelines relating to the conduct of clinical trials. With the introduction of ICH GCP, the conduct of clinical trials globally has become more uniform and practicable. Today, the implementation of ICH good clinical practice in most jurisdictions is reasonably similar, and the vast majority of the regulations are the same. Despite the effort of ICH, there still exists some local differences. For example, the US no longer adheres to the Declaration of Helsinki in its entirety, because the declaration considers placebo-controlled trials unethical in cases where an active drug is available. New privacy regulations in the EU and the financial disclosure requirements in the US are also making the clinical trial landscape more complicated. Healthcare product developers should therefore work to ICH in the context of local regulations. The regulations, guidance and industry standards that make up good clinical practice are intended to provide assurance that the rights, safety and well-being of clinical trial subjects are protected. GCP is also intended to assure that the research yields quality scientific data. Fundamentally, good clinical practice requires oversight of the local ethics committees, verification of the investigators' qualifications, a study protocol, investigator's brochure, informed consent, and the documentation that is essential for undertaking a clinical trial. Monitoring of the clinical trial. Submission of reports and maintenance of records. And the ICH GCP lays out the responsibilities of the ethics committees, sponsors, and investigators. The core principles of ICH good clinical practice are presented below. First, clinical trials should be conducted in accordance with the ethical principles that have their origin in the Declaration of Helsinki, and that are consistent with GCP and the applicable regulatory requirements. Second, before a trial is initiated, foreseeable risks and inconveniences should be weighed against the anticipated benefit for the individual trial subject and society. A trial should be initiated and continued only if the anticipated benefits justify the risks. Third, the rights, safety, and well-being of the trial subjects are the most important considerations and should prevail over interests of science and society. Fourth, the available non-clinical and clinical information on an investigational product should be adequate to support the proposed clinical trial. Fifth, clinical trials should be scientifically sound and described in a clear, detailed protocol. Sixth, a trial should be conducted in compliance with the protocol that has received prior institutional review board or the independent ethics committee approval. Seventh, the medical care and medical decisions given to subjects should always be the responsibility of a qualified physician or, when appropriate, of a qualified dentist. Eighth, each individual involved in conducting a trial should be qualified by education, training, and experience to perform his or her respective tasks. Ninth, freely given informed consent should be obtained from every subject prior to clinical trial participation. Tenth, All clinical trial information should be recorded, handled, and stored in a way that allows its accurate reporting, interpretation, and verification. 11th. The confidentiality of records that could identify subjects should be protected, respecting the privacy and confidentiality rules in accordance with the applicable regulatory requirements. 12. Investigational products should be manufactured, handled, and stored in accordance with applicable good manufacturing practice, GMP. They should be used in accordance with the approved protocol. And finally, 13. Systems with procedures that assure the quality of every aspect of the trial should be implemented. In summary, GCP helps protect the rights, safety, and well-being of clinical trial subjects and assures quality scientific data.